My name is Julia Huemer. I'm an MD. I'm a fully trained child and adolescent psychiatrist, initially from Austria, from Vienna, and I work at the Etkin Lab at Stanford as a postdoc. I grew up in a very tiny city in the heart of Lower Austria. Our town had only 6,000 or does have 6,000 inhabitants. My dad is a general practitioner, a family doctor there, and my mom is a kindergarten teacher, and at the same time she also studied painting at the Academy of Fine Arts. I studied art for half a year before I started studying medicine, so it was always the both aspects really in my life, very present. I like music very much, listening to music. I played some instruments also. Music is a wonderful tool to show your emotions, but also to set you into a different emotional state. Right now I'm doing mainly two things. I work on the study depressed adults by means of fMRI, TMS and EEG. And apart from that, I study a mathematical theory, which is called graph theory, in order to better understand network topology in the brain. People in our lab are very approachable. Our PI is a person who is very approachable and is really a very big source of inspiration to pass on enthusiasm about research to his collaborators. It's a team effort to really not only understand a tiny little bit of our field, but to really tackle the big questions in psychiatry and to find answers to these questions in order to reduce suffering. I'm really interested in human beings, and I really love working with human beings. And this can be like in a very direct way where you handle patients in a research setting, but then also in a very abstract way where you think about hypotheses and tools and study procedures and mechanisms. What led me to explore research to a larger extent was guided by my clinical practice, where very often you find it quite unsatisfying and disappointing that you can't provide the right treatments for patients and that you can't fully make them recover from their diseases. And out of these many questions arising from a clinical setting, not only about treatment outcomes but also about the etiology of the disease, meaning how does the disease develop and why. Out of these considerations, I was inspired to get more and more into research. So I'm very, very happy to work here and have an abundance of opportunities to learn and to explore.
Yeah, exactly. The standards are here.
But not here?
But not there. So it's not like the computer isn't actually...
Oh, okay.
What I love about science and research is that it entails a high level of creativity. Medicine is... it's just a wonderful profession because it includes so many aspects of being, and I found it very inspirational to understand or to try to understand the biology of our being and have that vision of trying to find answers to questions related to diseases and consequently reduce suffering.
What advice would you give to a high school student or an undergrad who wants to go into research or science or medicine, but for whatever reason they don't feel that they'd be able to do it?
Why would they feel that they wouldn't be able to do it?
I don't know. Maybe they think it's too hard, or maybe they think they wouldn't be welcome for some reason.
Mm-hmm. So we'd work on that, maybe. But generally, I think it's very, very important in every field, in every professional field, but also very important in research to find your passion. And then to really go out there and not let yourself... Let anyone prevent you from doing what you're really passionate about, what you feel is really right for you and your talents, and to always really feel that and go for that passion and then let this passion lead you to really work very hard on what you're most interested in. We'll be right back.